All right. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. It's dark. All right. All right. Well, welcome. We're all so glad to see you. We're glad you are here. Welcome to the 2023 Journey Youth and Miss Justine production of The New Stars.
Welcome, New Stars. You're both looking nice and bright this morning.
Boy, thank you, Old Star. We've been working on our shininess.
Good job, girls. And this is a great day for us to all look our best.
Why is that?
Because it's Christmas.
Hooray, Christmas! What's Christmas?
You don't know about Christmas? Oh, that's right. You're brand new, Stars. This is your first Christmas.
Yes. Is it your first Christmas too, Old Star?
Oh, no. I've actually seen over 2,000 of them.
2,000 Christmases? Wow, you don't look a day over 1,500.
2,000 Christmases? Is that like a lot?
Well, yes it is. In fact, I'm old enough to tell you both about the very first Christmas, and I can tell you why we still celebrate it.
Oh, yes, please do.
Yep, I can't wait to hear all about it.
Okay, to start, we have to go to a little place called Nazareth.
Is Nazareth the place up here in the sky?
No, silly. It's a place down on Earth. See that little planet right there?
You mean the one over there with all those fancy rings?
No, the one a little further to the right.
Duh, she means Pluto. Wait, I didn't even think that was a planet anymore.
Seriously, you two? Not Pluto or Saturn. Earth! Look! Right over there. That is the town of Nazareth.
Ooh, who's the pretty lady?
That's Mary. She's one of the main people in our story. She's pledged to marry a man named Joseph.
Ooh, romance. You didn't tell us there'd be romance in this story.
Keep watching. That's Joseph. He's a carpenter. He is a righteous man.
What's he doing?
Building something. Carpenters are always building something.
I hope it's a cradle.
I think you're getting ahead of our story.
Cool. Wait. You need your microphone. Set direction. Wait. Who's this guy? He's all shiny, just like we are.
That's Gabriel. He's an angel. He's come to talk to Mary. Let's listen.
Mary, do not be afraid. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be called Son of the Most High.
How can this be?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. He will be the Son of God.
I am the Lord's servant. May it be as you have said. Very
good. What did that all mean?
The angel told Mary she's going to have a baby who will be the Son of God.
What did Mary say?
Duh, she said yes.
Oh, okay, cool. Oh, well, that's really good. I like Mary. She seems really nice.
Oh, she is. After this, Mary hurried to visit her cousin, Elizabeth. That's Elizabeth. She's Mary's relative. She's also going to have a baby.
Another baby? Jeez! Don't drink the water down there.
No. Even though Elizabeth thought she was barren, God had blessed her with a baby.
I just love babies.
She looks kind of old to be having a baby.
Yeah, she is. But God had a great plan. Elizabeth's baby is going to be John. He's going to prepare the way for Jesus. John will grow up to baptize thousands, including Jesus.
Wow. Hey, Mary, you're having a baby?
Yeah.
I'm having a baby, too.
Belly bump.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for a long visit. Mary stayed with Elizabeth for a long visit and then returned home to Nazareth. By now, it was much more obvious she was going to have a baby.
But what about Joseph? What did Joseph say about all of this?
Well, Joseph knew the baby wasn't his because God sent an angel to speak to him in a dream.
Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save people from their sins.
I will name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
Wow, what a great name.
Yeah, it is. And since Joseph was a good and righteous man, he was obedient to God and married Mary.
Well, that's cool. But what happens next?
Well, there was a little drama going on in Rome. Caesar, the Roman ruler, ordered that everyone had to be counted.
Why would he do that?
Something about taxes.
Taxes, whatever those are.
Everyone had to go to their hometown to be counted.
Sort of like a family reunion?
A little bit, but without the games and potato salad.
Well, that's too bad. I love potato salad. Well, did they at least have cookies?
Yeah, cookies. I love cookies.
I don't think so.
Well, then it doesn't sound very much like a family reunion to me.
In fact, it was a long, hard trip for Mary and Joseph, especially since Mary was due to have the baby soon.
Where did they have to go?
They went to a little town called Bethlehem.
You mean that little itty-bitty town over there in the middle of nowhere?
That's the one. It was the birthplace of Joseph's ancestor, King David.
Wait a minute. Bethlehem. Isn't that the one they sing about? The one where they're like, oh, little town of Bethlehem?
Yup.
That's my favorite song. They even sing about how the silent stars go by.
I wonder what it would be like to be surrounded by silent stars.
Wait, listen. I think I can hear people start to sing it now.
Please stand with us as we sing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Yeah.
You people can really sing. But I thought this was a story about Christmas.
Yeah, when do we get to the part about the tree, presents, and star?
There was no tree, but there were presents and a star.
Where?
We're getting there. First, we have to hear more about Mary and Joseph.
Oh, look, they finally arrived in Bethlehem. It looks busy down there. I hope they can find a hotel with a good breakfast.
Oh, poor Mary. She looks so tired.
You're right, but there was no place for them to stay at a hotel, so they ended up in a stable.
A stable? Do you mean a place for stinky farm animals?
You mean that's what that smell is? I thought that was you, old star.
Let's focus here, girls. Honestly, it was probably the safest and best place for them. I'm sure Joseph made it comfy for Mary.
Look, the baby, he's here.
Whoa! Oh man, we missed it. He's so cute and tiny.
What did they name him?
They named him Jesus, which means the Lord saves. And now, for the first time, there was a new star in the sky, which announced the birth of the Messiah.
A new star? How exciting! I bet no one on earth could have missed that.
Well, they did, just like people miss his signs today. But God didn't rely on just a star to announce the birth of his son. He also sent an angel to tell a group of shepherds all about it.
The angel again?
Yep, but this time he brought friends. A whole group appeared.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. He is Christ the Lord.
Suddenly, there are a whole bunch of angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace and goodwill towards men." Then the angels left, and the shepherds said to each other, so they hurried and found Mary, Joseph, and the baby, who was lying in a manger, just like they were told. They told everyone who they had seen and heard.
Well, I would tell everybody too, and I'd snap about it.
Already did. Post sent.
Please stand with us as we sing "Angels We Have Heard on High."
Angels we have heard.
Christmas and the star?
Yep, but the story isn't over yet. Look over there in the east.
Who the heck are those overdressed dudes?
Hey, wait a minute. Are those presents?
Is this a birthday party?
Wait, so there are presents?
Yes, there were gifts. I already said that. Those are the wise men.
Wise men?
Well, that's what they call themselves. They're actually kings. You know what they say? We three kings of Orient are... bearing gifts we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
Oh, I get it. They saw the new star, and they followed it because they were wise enough to know that it meant that the Savior had been born.
That's right. Let's sing about it.
We three kings of
I like those kings. And look, I love that they brought presents.
Who are they for, that mean-looking guy?
No, they're for baby Jesus. They brought gold because Jesus is the king, frankincense because he is a high priest, and myrrh because of Jesus' sacrifice.
Well, hey, where are they going? Bethlehem's over there. You're going the wrong way, kings. The baby's over there.
They're going to Jerusalem to find the king of the Jews.
But why? The baby's in Bethlehem, over there.
They went looking for the baby king in a palace, but they didn't find him there.
Well, then who did they find?
An evil man named Herod, who was the local ruler.
Dun, dun, dun!
I heard those other kings traveled all the way here with my gifts. Where are my gifts? I am king. I want my presents and I want them now. Where are those guys?
Sorry, king. They gave your gifts to the new king.
New king? Who's the new king? I'm the only king around here. Someone better tell me who he is and where he's at. I want to meet this new king. And when I find him, there will only be one king left. Come and tell me so that I can worship him too.
Oh, he's so scary. I don't like him.
Is he gone yet?
Yeah, he's gone.
He's so creepy.
So the wise men went and followed the star until it stopped over where Jesus was. When they found him, they were so excited and worshiped him. They gave Jesus their gifts and then headed back to their own country. And did not tell Herod who they had found.
Well, yeah, no doubt. I wouldn't tell him either. That guy is creepy.
Yep, bad dude for sure.
Don't worry about Jesus. He was safe. An angel came to warn Joseph in a dream to take his family to Egypt so that they would be safe, and Herod never found them.
Yay for the good guys.
Awesome story. How do you know all of this?
Oh, I saw it all from up here in the sky. You see, I am the new star that appeared that night.
Really? You're a new star too?
But you're so old.
Yeah, she's really old.
This story is over 2,000 years old, but it's still as true today as it was in that very first Christmas. And that, girls, is why we still celebrate Christmas, even after all these years.
I think I'll try.
That's amazing. This is the best first day of training ever.
I think I'll shine a little brighter now that I know how special we are.
We are special, and the story doesn't end there. That small baby, Jesus, grew into a man. He's God's only son sent to earth. Isaiah 9, 6 through 7 says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace." Jesus came in human form. He humbled himself by being obedient to the point of death, even his death on a cross. Jesus died so that everyone who believed in him and called on his name will be saved. John 3:16 says, "For that God so loved the world that he gave his only son, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." That small baby, wherever he is the savior of the world.
Wow, that is beautiful. But, okay, so now what?
Looks like it's time for another song.
And cookies. I love cookies.
Yep, why don't we sing Joy to the World? Yes, we will have some cookies. Come on. Please stand with us as we sing Joy to the World.
Receive her King.
Well, wasn't that fun? That was good. Let's give him another hand, shall we? You guys did great. You did awesome. I love the baby bump. That was so cool. Don't do that in real life. But that was fun. Can we take a bow? Yay. Can you bow? Good job. All right. Oh, Gabriel came out of hiding. Good job, Gabriel. All right, guys, you can go be seated. I'm going to ask Miss Amy and my wife to stay up here, though, for just a moment. Oh, yes, stars?
Yes.
Take your bow, too. Good job. I appreciate my wife standing in as a second. She originally was not supposed to be a star, but one of the girls was not feeling well, so she stepped in the last minute. Most of you don't know, but this entire play was written by both of these, by Pastor Justine and Amy. They not only wrote it, they produced it, and they directed it. So we want to give them just a little something to recognize their hard work. Yes, thank you.